First of all, what is a catheter? So a urinary catheter is a soft hollow tube which is passed into the bladder to drain urine. Catheters are sometimes necessary for people who, for a variety of reasons, cannot empty their bladder in the usual way, that is passing urine into the toilet or urinal. So now for the type of catheters. First is a straight catheter. They are usually made of soft rubber or plastic. These catheters are used to drain the bladder and they do not remain in the bladder. The round top tip of this straight catheter reduces urethral trauma as the catheter is passed and the urine enters the lumen of the catheter through the two eye holes. It is used when the catheter is to be inserted and removed immediately. The indwelling catheter, also known as Foley's catheter, is left inside the bladder to provide continuous urine drainage. This catheter has a balloon surrounding the neck, which is inflated after the catheter is introduced into the bladder. The suprapubic catheter is a type of indwelling catheter and is inserted into the bladder through surgical incision made in the abdominal wall right above the pubic bone. It is commonly used for the patient who has blocked urethra. The condom catheter is an external catheter used on males. It is applied over the penis and attached to drainage tubing to the leg. It collects urine in the inconscient or unconscious patient who has complete and spontaneous bladder emptying. Check upon patient from time to check for urine output, and if the catheter is still in place and is not hurting the patient, measure the amount of drainage in the collection bag at the end of each shift and record the information in the I&O sheet and notify the nurse if the redness, burning, pain or irritation are observed on the patient.
Burning sensation, then report it to the nurse. And check for redness and swollen area around the catheter. Sir, may I? Okay. So everything looks normal here.
Check for the urine output in the drainage bag and see for the change in color in the urine or any presence of blood in the urine, then report it to the nurse. Observation, in the first hour it is 50 ml of the urine in the drainage bag. Urine output is observed 280 ml in 4 hours. So we can say the patient is having normal urine output.